Today, we are going to discuss about Leon Bursky line clipping algorithm. We already discussed about Kogan-Sarland line clipping algorithm with respect to line clipping, where in Kogan-Sarland line clipping algorithm, we calculate the endpoints based on the regions. Okay. Now, we move on to Leon Bursky line clipping algorithm. In Leon Bursky line clipping algorithm, where the algorithm that uses floating point arithmetic but find the appropriate endpoints with at most four computation. Those more four computations are with respect to bottom and left, top and right. This algorithm uses parametric equation for a line and solves four inequalities to find the range of the parameter for which the line is in the viewport, which means the four inequalities that says about when you are going to calculate with respect to the left window, what is the calculation bit with respect to left window? X1 minus X window minimum. Similarly, with respect to right, X window maximum minus X1. And here, with respect to top, Y window maximum minus Y1. With respect to bottom, Y1 minus Y window minimum. Okay. So, based on these four bottom, top, left, right. Okay, four region where you are going to calculate using parametric equation to find out the clipped edges of given lines. As you can see here two different endpoints. One endpoint has the value of x1, y1, another endpoint has the value of x2, y2. Okay, so here we are considering T, that T is the intersection point calculation. Okay, T starting from this point to this endpoint. Okay, what is the distance traveled? Where initial at this point T is equal to 0, at this endpoint T is equal to 1. Okay, so considering this t value, at initial point t equal to 0, at end point t equal to 1. So you are going to calculate based on this particular t value. Okay. So here we are going to use the parametric equation of the line. Okay. Considering the line endpoints, P1 is x1, y1 and P2 is x2, y2. So, considering the t range from at this initial point, t is equal to 0. At this end point, t is equal to 1. Okay. At the start point of the line, t is equal to 0. And end point of the line, t equal to 1. What you are going to check here, suppose, for example, the initial point P1, X1, Y1, T is equal to 0. At end point, P2, X2, Y2, where the T equal to 1. Okay. So, here, the T already traveled 3 by 4th of distance to reach X2. The T is already traveled 3 by 4th of distance to reach X2. So, when you are going to write this in parametric equation, at 3 by 4th of line path, the value of t is equal to 3 by 4. So at this point of location, you have to describe your x as well as y intersection point values with respect to two different endpoints, x1, y1 and x2, y2. How will you write? Here, intersection point of x value is equal to, okay, 3/4 distance t already traveled to reach x2. So what is remaining? 1/4. So 1/4 distance t traveled by this x1 to reach x2. Okay. Similarly for y. Okay. At t is equal to 3/4 distance, t equal to 3/4 distance, t is traveled 3/4 distance to reach x2. So what is remaining distance to reach x2? 1/4. So t x1 has to travel 1/4 distance to reach x2. So when you are going to write at time t, x is equal to 1 minus t into x1 plus t into x2, which means t 3/4 distance already traveled to reach x2. What is remaining is to reach x1, 1 minus this given value t. That distance will carry with x1 to reach x2. So when you are going to write at time t, x is equal to 1 minus t into x1 plus t into x2. Similarly, y is equal to 1 minus t into y1 plus t into y2. I repeat again, there are two different endpoints of the line. One endpoint of line says p1 is equal to x1 comma y1, and another endpoint is p2 is x2 comma y2. In here, we are going to, in Lyon-Barsky algorithm, we are going to calculate based on the parametric equation. So to find the parametric equation of the line, here we are considering t value at initial stage of your endpoint t equal to 0. At endpoint of stage, your t value is equal to 1. So what you are going to calculate here, what is the distance t traveled between these two endpoints? Okay. Here, the t already traveled 3/4 distance to reach x2. What is remaining? 1 minus 3/4. That is 1/4. So 1/4 distance of x1 to be traveled to reach x2. Based on this, at 3/4 of the line path, t is equal to 3/4. The location is new intersection point of x and y. So x is equal to 1/4 distance yet to travel to reach x2. Already t traveled 3/4 distance to reach x2. Similarly, same you write on y, 1/4 into y1 plus 3/4 into y2. This is at, we says at location t equal to 3/4. Same you write at time t with respect to t, in view of t when you are going to write. So 1 minus t into x1 plus t into x2. Similarly for y, 1 minus t into y1 plus t into y2. You elaborate these two equations. X is equal to 1 minus t into x1 plus t into x2. And you're going to write, multiply 1 minus t with x1, x1 minus t into x1 plus t into x2. X is equal to x1 plus common factor between these two is t. Take it out. So x2 minus x1. So final equation for calculating intersection point at x is equal to x1 plus t into dx. Okay. Similarly, for y, y is equal to 1 minus t into y1 plus t into y2, where y is equal to y1 minus t into y1 plus t into y2. So simplify again, y1 plus common factor t, take it out, y2 minus y1. So you will get y is equal to y1 plus t into dy. So your parametric line equation is x is equal to x1 plus t into dx, y is equal to y1 plus t into dy. Right? Next, we know that your x value and y value is between x window minimum and maximum boundaries. Okay, with respect to x, it is between x window minimum and x window maximum boundary. With respect to y window minimum and y window maximum boundary, x value is going to be greater than or equal to x window minimum, less than or equal to x window maximum. Similarly, y value is going to be greater than or equal to y window minimum, less than or equal to y window maximum. So substitute your x and y value over here. Your x value is going to be x1 plus t into dx. Your y value is going to be y1 plus t into dy. Right? So make it again simple. Your x1 plus t into dx is greater than or equal to x window minimum. Okay? X1 plus t into dx is less than or equal to x window maximum. Further, you simplify this, you will get again y1 plus t into dy is greater than or equal to y window minimum. Y1 plus t into dy is less than or equal to y window maximum. Fine. So you keep it t into dx this side and move x window minimum minus x1 that side. Similarly, t into dx, x window maximum minus x1, t into dy, y window minimum minus y1, t into dy, y window maximum minus y1. Here you are going to see four inequalities. Okay, one is greater than or equal to, another one is less than or equal to. So to make similarities of these four inequalities, make it less than or equal to with respect to your t into dx. So for that, what you have to do, make equalities in four different equations, multiply with minus 1. When you are going to multiply with minus 1 at this equation, minus t into dx is less than or equal to x1 minus x window minimum, and t into dx is less than or equal to x window maximum minus x1. Again, here minus t into dy is less than or equal to y1 minus y window minimum. T into dy is less than or equal to y window maximum minus y1. So what are the value changed in this? Your first x1 minus x window minimum, this value got changed. Again, here y1 minus y window minimum, this value got changed. So second and fourth value remains same. Okay, so here this, how we can write this equation, T into Pk less than or equal to Qk, where this you can see already we have discussed in Kogan-Sarlan line clipping algorithm to calculate the bit value. Okay, whereas x1 minus x window minimum says about bit left, x window maximum minus x1 bit right, y1 minus y window minimum bit bottom, y window maximum minus y1 bit top. Okay, so further we can write this, we can represent this equation T into Pk less than or equal to Qk, where k is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 bits. Okay, and how we can write where T into Pk less than or equal to Qk, where we can write this Pk value and Qk value, P1 is equal to minus dx, P2 is equal to dx, P3 equal to minus dy, P4 equal to dy. Similarly, Q1 we can write x1 minus x window minimum, Q2 is equal to x window maximum minus x1, Q3 is equal to y1 minus y window minimum, Q4 is equal to y window maximum minus y1 from these equations, right? P1, P2, P3, P4. Similarly, Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4. P1 is minus dx, P2 is dx, P3 is minus dy, P4 is dy, Q1 is x1 minus x window minimum, Q2 is x window maximum minus x1, Q3 is y1 minus y window minimum, Q4 is y window maximum minus y1. Right? So now what we have to check, whether the line is inside the boundary or outside the boundary, you are going to check based on these different cases. First, your Pk value is less than zero. If Pk value is less than zero, means as t increases, then line goes from outside to inside, which means if Pk is less than zero, the line is on entry point. Line is on entry point means t is equal to zero. If Pk is greater than zero, line goes from inside to outside. Okay, inside to outside, then here you have to calculate t equal to 1 at this point. Okay, if Pk is less than 0, as t increases, line goes from outside to inside, which means at entry point, which means here the calculation of value you have to consider t equal to 0. If Pk is greater than 0, line goes from inside to outside, which means at exit point. Exit point is t equal to 1. If Pk is equal to 0, line is parallel to an edge, which means outside the window, it is parallel to an edge. So at this condition, you can just reject the particular line. So you have to consider Pk less than 0 and greater than 0, these two conditions for clipping. Next, similarly for Q1, Q2, Q3, and Q4. If Q is less than 0, the line is completely outside of the window. Okay. If Q is greater than 0, line is inside or partially inside, which means this is the window. Okay. If Q is greater than 0, line is inside the boundary. Okay. Either the both the endpoints may be inside the boundary or partially inside, which means from one endpoint of line is partially inside, other endpoint line also partially inside. In this case, what you have to do, you have to calculate the intersection point at this level. Next, QK is equal to 0, then line is within the boundary or partial, which means line here, you can see the example for QK equal to 0, line is within the boundary or partial. So for this, you have to calculate your intersection point with respect to T, and you will get new intersected value of X and Y. Okay. So once again, I will repeat the condition with respect to P and Q. If P value is less than 0, then T increases, which means it is T at starting point, T equal to 0. The line goes from outside to inside, which means entry point. So next, if P is greater than 0, the line goes inside to outside, which means at exit point, at T equal to 1. Okay. If PK is equal to 0, line is parallel to an edge outside the window, it may be parallel to the edge. Next, if Q is less than 0, the line is completely outside, it may be parallel. If QK is greater than 0, the line is inside, partially inside. Okay. If QK is equal to 0, line is within the boundary or partial. Okay. Partial means the two different edges are not exactly at clipped window. Okay. So these are the condition. So now we write the algorithm. First, step one, get the line endpoints of P1 is equal to X1 comma Y1, 2, P2 is equal to X2 comma Y2. Find difference of X, difference of Y, P1, P2, P3, P4, and Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4. Find difference of X, difference of Y. P1 is equal to minus dx. P2 is equal to dx. P3 is equal to minus dy. P4 is equal to dy. Q1 is equal to x1 minus x window minimum. Q2 is equal to x window maximum minus x1. Q3 equal to y1 minus y window minimum. Q4 is equal to y window maximum minus y1. Okay. Third, assign t1 is equal to 0, t2 equal to 1. Assign the values at initial. T1 is equal to 0, starting point of the endpoint line, and t2 equal to 1, endpoint of T value. Okay. If PK is equal to 0, then the line is parallel to the window. If QK is less than 0, then the line is outside the window. Apart from these two cases, for non-zero value of PK, you have to calculate if pk is less than 0, then it is at the starting point. So you have to find t1. The line is passing from entry point to inside the clipped window. So you have to find t1. Then what is the t1 value? T1 value is equal to maximum of t value equal to 0 at starting point, comma q by p, qk by pk. This qk represents q1, comma q2, comma q3, comma q4. Pk represents p1, p2, p3, p4. Else, pk is greater than 0, then at exit point, t equal to t2. So t2 equal to 1. So you have to find t2. T2 is equal to minimum of your TT value should be 1, comma QK divided by PK. Where similarly here, Q1 by P1, Q2 by P2, Q3 by P3, Q4 by P4. Okay. If T1 is greater than T2, then line is completely outside. You reject it. Else, find the new set of x comma y if t1 or t2 changes. If t1 or t2 changes, x equal to x1 plus t into dx with respect to x intersection point, y is equal to y1 plus t into dy with respect to y intersection points. Got it? So here, based on these two conditions, we are going to run our parametric equation of the line. If pk is less than 0, the t value is at entry point. T value is equal to 0. So you have to find the t1 is equal to maximum of 0, comma qk and pk. And pk is greater than 0, the line is at exit point. You have to find out t2 value. T2 value is equal to 1. Okay, so t2 equal to minimum of 1, comma qk by pk. So by considering at entry point t value equal to 0, by considering at exit point t value equal to 1, you have to calculate the values of t1 and t2. Okay, so from this algorithm, T is a intersection point in the boundary. When T1 is equal to 0 and T2 equal to 1, then the endpoints are completely inside the boundary. If this is the boundary, your T1 value equal to 0, T2 value equal to 1 means the both the line endpoints are inside the boundary. You no need to find any clipping. Else, not inside, you have to calculate the intersection points with respect to the edge points. First, line passes from outside to inside. Line passes from outside to inside, then T1 changes, which means here you have to calculate the entry point of T is equal to 0. Here T1 changes, T1 is not equal to 0, then you have to calculate T1 maximum of initial T1 value is equal to 0, comma QK divided by PK. Within in these two, what is the maximum value that is going to be your T1? Then line passes from inside the clipped window to outside. In this case, here you have to calculate the exit point of T. So T2 changes, which means T2 is not equal to 1. Then this case you have to calculate T2 is equal to minimum of 1, comma Q divided by P. In these two values, what is the minimum that you have to consider for T2? Suppose the line passes through a clipped window. Okay, at in this case, at entry point, T1 also changes. At the exit point, T2 also changes. Here, T1 is not equal to 0. Similarly, T1 is not equal to 1. So, both the cases, what you have to do, you have to calculate the intersection point. When entry point changes, T1 changes, your new intersection point of x is equal to x1 plus t1 into dx, y value is equal to y1 plus t1 into dy. At this point, if t2 is changes at exit point, x equal to x1 plus t2 into dx, y equal to y1 plus t2 into dy. Right? At this point, you are both t1 and t2 changes. So, x equal to x1 plus t1 into dx, y equal to y1 plus t1 into dy. At point t2, x equal to x1 plus t2 into dx, y equal to y1 plus t2 into dy.